Welcome to WTFacts Chronicles, where reality is always stranger than fiction.
Last time on WTFacts Chronicles, we uncovered killer robots, designer babies, human cloning, mass surveillance, and quantum computers. But that was only the beginning. Because today, the controversies cut even deeper. Nanobots that can heal or kill, brain implants that can cure disease or steal thoughts, AI that replaces millions of jobs, experiments that try to control the planet's climate. And the most haunting question of all, can we cheat death itself? This is part two of the dark side of technology. Let's begin. Chronicle 48, AI and mass job loss. Artificial intelligence is moving at lightning speed. It's already writing news articles, generating art, analyzing medical scans, and even driving cars. Back in 2017, McKinsey warned that by 2030, up to 800 million jobs worldwide could be automated. That's nearly one in five workers on Earth. And it's not just theory, it's happening now. In Japan, hotels run with robot concierges. In the US, call centers use AI chatbots instead of human staff. Even doctors and lawyers, professions once thought untouchable, are seeing AI systems review contracts or x-rays faster than humans. And what about creativity? AI tools can make paintings, write novels, even compose music in seconds. In 2023, Hollywood writers and actors went on strike, partly out of fear that studios would replace human creativity with algorithms. The big question, will AI create new industries, like the internet once did? Or will it hollow out society, where the few who own the machines grow richer and everyone else is left behind? Imagine a future where humans compete against tireless, perfect workers who never sleep, never complain, never need paychecks. What happens to our identity when even creativity isn't safe? And if AI is taking away our jobs, another invention threatens something even more personal, our very thoughts. Chronicle 49, brain-computer interfaces. Imagine controlling a computer, not with your hands, but with your mind. That's the promise of brain-computer interfaces. In 2020, Elon Musk's Neuralink showed the world a pig with a brain implant that transmitted live data to a computer. In 2023, researchers went further. A paralyzed man controlled a computer cursor and typed words purely by thinking without touching a keyboard. The potential is incredible. A blind person could regain sight. A soldier with injuries could walk again. Patients with Alzheimer's could recover lost memories. But power always comes with a shadow. If a machine can read your thoughts, who owns that information? What happens if a hacker taps into your memories? Or if governments demand access to what people are secretly thinking? Critics warn this could lead to the ultimate surveillance, where no idea, no secret, no private dream is truly safe. And what about influence? If implants can send signals back into the brain, could they shape emotions, even control decisions? Imagine ads directly inserted into your thoughts. Or worse, a government implant that punishes dissent before it's even spoken aloud. A tool designed to heal could also erase the last line of human freedom. And while brain implants may rewrite what it means to be human, other scientists are trying to rewrite the planet itself. Chronicle 50, climate engineering. Climate change is real, and it's urgent. With rising seas, melting glaciers, and record-breaking heat waves, some scientists argue that we need more than renewable energy. We need to hack the planet itself. This radical idea is called geoengineering. One method? Spraying reflective particles high into the atmosphere, essentially creating a man-made shield to bounce sunlight back into space. Another? Dumping iron into oceans to trigger plankton blooms that suck carbon dioxide out of the air. Sounds like a quick fix. But here's the danger. Earth's systems are interconnected. Cool one region, and another might plunge into drought. Change the rainfall in Asia, and crops across Africa could fail. In 2021, Harvard researchers planned a small test in Sweden. But the public pushed back, terrified that even a tiny experiment could trigger irreversible consequences. The project was canceled before it even began. And here's the darker scenario. What if geoengineering becomes a weapon? If a powerful nation can control rainfall, imagine crops thriving at home while rival nations starve. Weather warfare, hidden in plain sight. So the question is, do we dare risk fixing the planet by playing God? Or is the cure worse than the disease? And if changing the planet's weather sounds dangerous, the next invention goes even smaller, down to the invisible world of nanotech. Chronicle 51, Nanotechnology as a Weapon. Nanotechnology works at a scale so small, it's almost impossible to comprehend. We're talking about particles measured in billionths of a meter, smaller than a single cell in your body. In medicine, the dream is breathtaking. Nanobots could repair organs, attack cancer directly, or deliver drugs exactly where they're needed. A hospital inside your bloodstream. But here's the nightmare. The same nanobots could be weaponized. Imagine particles scattered in the air, programmed to shred human lung tissue. Or tiny machines hidden in food or water, silent, invisible assassins that poison entire populations. In 2008, a U.S. intelligence report warned that nanotechnology could become the next frontier of weapons of mass destruction. Unlike nuclear bombs, there'd be no mushroom cloud, no warning sirens. Just invisible particles, spreading uncontrollably. And the scariest part? Once released, weaponized nanotech might mutate, replicate, and adapt, like a virus humanity cannot stop. The question is chilling. If the next arms race is fought with particles too small to see, how can anyone ever feel safe? And while nanobots could destroy our bodies, the final invention dares to challenge death itself. Chronicle 52, Digital Immortality. Humans have always dreamed of living forever. From ancient myths of eternal youth to modern sci-fi, immortality is the ultimate fantasy. But now, technology might make it more than a dream. The idea is digital immortality, scanning the human brain, uploading memories, and preserving personality inside a computer. In 2015, Russian billionaire Dmitry Itskov launched the 2045 initiative, aiming to transfer human consciousness into robotic avatars. In the US, companies like Nectome are experimenting with brain preservation, hoping to one day revive minds in digital form. The vision? Living forever, free from disease, pain, and decay. But here's the philosophical horror. Is a digital copy really you, or just software pretending to be you? If your consciousness is uploaded, does your soul follow? Or does the real you still die? And then there's the social divide. What if only the rich can afford immortality? Imagine a future where billionaires live forever, shaping the world endlessly, while everyone else remains mortal. Immortality might save us, or it might split humanity into two species, those who live forever and those who don't. It's humanity's oldest wish, but maybe also its most dangerous gamble. From AI taking jobs, to nanobots that kill, to digital immortality, these breakthroughs force us to ask not just what we can invent, but what we should. Technology is powerful, but it's also dangerous. The future we build depends not just on what we create, but on the choices we make. So what do you think? Should humanity chase these breakthroughs no matter the risks? Or are some doors better left closed? Tell us in the comments. And don't forget to subscribe to WT Facts Chronicles, because the future is only getting stranger, and our journey is far from over.